Now, alhamdulillah, we are near the masjid. Say Ashuada.
Sayyid Ashuada.
Sayyid Ashuada, alhamdulillah.
Medina, 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 Nabi, Medina, Medina.
My dreams, I make my way to Medina. In my dreams, I make my way to Medina.
And just in front of the masjid, there's the place that the Prophet Muhammad ate the most. It's a souk.
Souk, yeah.
Souk. They sell things just in front of the masjid. So, and the masjid is there. Alhamdulillah. So, let's visit it, inshallah.
وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. We are at Uhud. If you see behind there, all that over there is the mountain of Uhud. Stretching from that corner there all the way to the other side. It's roughly around 7 kilometers long and 3 kilometers wide that way. That is the mountain of Uhud itself. And where we're standing in this area here is the area where the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and the Muslims fought in the Battle of Uhud against the disbelievers of Quraysh. So the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when he left the morning of the battlefield from Al-Medina, Al-Medina and the Haram is down in that direction over there. Okay, we are in the north end of the city. So this area at the time of the Prophet ﷺ was in the outskirts of the city of Al-Medina. Prophet ﷺ came with his army, marched all the way here, and he prepared his stations with the mountain to the back of the army. So the army was facing this way, and the mountain was towards the back. And the Quraysh came from the direction of Mecca, which was down in that direction. It came this way. And the battle taqriban took place approximately in the area where we're standing right now. This hill that you see right here on the left, over here, that's where the Messenger of Allah placed the archers of 50 men. He chose 50 men from the companions to stand on that hill. Actually, the hill was a lot bigger before, but due to erosion, it became a little smaller. It's a lot bigger before. But that's where they were, radiallahu anhum. The Prophet commanded them to stay up there. So he put them, the army there, and the battalions, the 5 battalions, were placed here in between the hill and the hill over there. And it was here approximately where the army of the Muslims were camped out against the disbelievers who came from that direction. Obviously, the story of Battle of Uhud was a really long story. However, this was the battle that took place due to the fact that the disbelievers of Quraysh wanted to revenge the Muslims for what took place in Badr a year before. Right, a year before, the Muslims were victorious in Badr. Badr is about 150 kilometers outside of the city of Al-Medina, roughly. And the disbelievers decided to come and they wanted to attack Medina and the Muslims. So the Prophet ﷺ decided to come out and camp here, right? So when they came out here, the army was about 700, because initially they came out as 1,000 men, but 300 of them pulled back. The hypocrites, they pulled back. And the Prophet ﷺ and the 700 men that were remaining came and fought here. And the fighting actually took place here. Many incidents took place in this battle, but eventually, when the Muslims began to chase the disbelievers away and the disbelievers began to run back that way, the Muslims chased them that way, and the other Muslims that are up on this hill decided to come down to go after the spoils of war that were in the area. And when that occurred, few of them remained up in the hill, but most of them came down, disobeying the Messenger ﷺ's command to stay on the mountain no matter what happens. Khalid ibn al-Walid, who was not a Muslim at that time, radiallahu anhu, he was in the army of the disbelievers, came with a group of horsemen around that hill. He came around that hill and came and attacked the Muslims from behind. So when he did that, the disbelievers on the other side started to come back, and in the middle is where a lot of chaos took place here. A lot of chaos took place. Some of the companions of the Prophet ﷺ were killed. The Prophet ﷺ himself was injured, alayhi salatu wasalam. And eventually the Muslims had to fall back and retreat towards Uhud, back over there. And that happened here. 70 companions of the Prophet ﷺ that day passed away. From amongst them, the uncle of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Hamza, radiallahu anhu, who was known as Sayyid al-Shuhada. And that masjid is named after him, Masjid Sayyid al-Shuhada, referring to Hamza radiallahu anhu. Similarly, other great companions like Mus'ab ibn Umair radiallahu anhu. Similarly, other companions such as Abdullah ibn Jahsh and Handala and other companions passed away and were killed in this Battle of Uhud, and all of them are buried in there. Within this closing here, in there is where the graves of the 70 companions of the Prophet ﷺ are buried here. And the Prophet ﷺ used to actually come quite often, leave Medina and come here and visit the grave of those companions radiallahu anhu. And this is one of the places in the city of Al-Madinah where it is from the Sunnah to go and visit. The graveyard of the Shuhada of Uhud, similarly the graveyard of Baqi', which is by the Masjid of the Prophet ﷺ, and the two masjids, Masjid al-Nabi ﷺ and Masjid Quba, these are from the places where it is from the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ to come and visit. So those companions are buried here, radiallahu anhum. So that's in summary, I mean, the lessons that can be taken out from the Battle of Uhud are many, and the story is a lot longer than this short video that we're making here. However, we go back to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we see what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Ali Imran, particularly with regards to what happened in this event, and the lessons that are derived from the incident that happened here in this on the Battle of Uhud. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have mercy, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he says, he is pleased with his companions. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have mercy on them, and we ask Allah to allow us to follow in their path and striving for the religion and establishing the sunnah and following the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to connect us with them in the paradise. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to be those who are firm upon their way. If there's anything that I said that is of benefit or good, is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If there's any shortcomings I've said, it's from my own shortcomings. And that is just a quick summary of what happened here in Uhud.